Hi friends, in the last video we discussed the sampling theorem in which we change our analog signal into the sampled signal to change our signal from analog to digital. Now in this video we see how to reconstruct our message signal from the sampled signal, because at the receiver side we have to again change digital signal into the analog form. So for that we have to change our sampled signal into the analog signal. So for that we pass our sampled signal xx of t through a low pass filter. Low pass filter is a combination of resistance and the capacitor in which sampled signal is applied as the input and output is noticed across the capacitor as the capacitor voltage. So capacitor charge according to the sampled value that is stored in the sampled signal. And in last, we assembled all the capacitor voltage and we reconstruct our message signal x of t. So we noticed a 3 sample signal and we passed this sampled signal through a low pass filter. So capacitor noticed the value of sampled A, B and C at the 0, 1 and 2 instant. And capacitor charge up to A value at 0 instant, then B value at 1 instant, and it charges up to C at 2 instant. And in last we joined all these peak of the capacitor voltage, and in this way according to the joint signal we reconstruct our message signal as x of t. In the frequency domain our sampled signal is denoted by x of f, that is f of s summation n is vary from minus infinity to plus infinity xf minus n f of s, in which our message signal that is centered about 0 repeat itself after the fs interval with the amplitude of fs. So we have a triangle at center and one at fs, then 2fs, and this will be from minus infinity to plus infinity with the magnitude of fs. Now we have to choose our message signal from this sampled signal that is focused about the origin. So we pass this sampled signal from a low pass filter, but we choose the magnitude of the low pass filter as 1 by fs, because our sampled signal has a magnitude of fs, so we have to cancel out this fs term. So we choose low pass filter magnitude as 1 by fs, and in the frequency domain when we multiply x of f with h of f, this term of magnitude will be cancelled out and we got our message signal as a magnitude of 1. So when we pass this sampled signal through a low pass filter, we obtained our original message signal that is centered about the origin and whose frequency is band limited to the fm hertz. Then we change this message signal from frequency domain to the time domain and we got our original message signal as we transmit through the transmitter. Ideal, our low pass filter is like a rectangular shape with the magnitude of 1 and the frequency is limited to the ideal cutoff frequency. But in practical, low pass filter is not like a rectangular shape. It will be a trapezoidal in which wide side will be some tilted like that. Now we will see the mathematical proof of obtaining our x of f, that is our original message signal. So x of f is equal to x of f multiplied with h of f. As we know that the multiplication in frequency domain is convolution in the time domain. So it will be x of t convolved with h of t. By the subject of signal and system, you know that convolved sign will change like this equation. That is summation k is vary from minus infinity to plus infinity x and ts h t minus k ts. As one domain rectangular pulse is the sync pulse in the another domain, so ideally our low pass filter is of rectangular shape, so in another domain it will be a sync pulse. So this equation will change like summation k is vary from minus infinity to plus infinity x and ts sync 2 pi fm t minus k ts. So by putting the value of our sampled signal we find our x of t. So we find our x of f by multiplying our sampled signal with a low pass filter with the magnitude of 1 by fs. Now we will see why fs is very very greater than twice of fm, that is oversampling, and we practically perform this sampling. In this figure, sampled signal x of f is denoted, in which our original message signal, that is centered about the origin, repeat itself after the fs frequency. Because fs is greater than twice of fm, so in the diagram it is clear that the distance from 0 to fm hertz frequency is fm, and the distance between fs minus fm to fs is also fm, and the gap between fm to fs minus fm is called as the guard band. And fs is greater than twice of fm because of this guard band gap. So fs is high than the twice of fm. Then we pass this sampled signal through a low pass filter, and because of this guard band we can easily recover our message signal. So to recover our message signal back, we always perform fs greater than twice of fm, then we can easily without distortion recover our message signal. Next is the critical sampling, in which fs is equal to the twice of fm, in which the distance between the fm and fm minus fs is 0, or we can say that fm equal to fm minus fs. So all the triangle start after each other and there is no guard band. So when this signal is passed through the low pass filter, we recover our message signal without distortion when we use the ideal low pass filter. So this is the ideal case to recover our message signal, but ideally low pass filter is not possible, so we generally do not use this method to recover our message signal, that is fs equal to twice of fm. Now in the next, fs is less than twice of fm, that is under sampling. As fs is less than twice of fm, so fm minus fs is less as compared to fm. So when we pass this through a low pass filter, because one triangle associate with other triangle, or we can say one triangle is inside the other triangle, so when we pass the low pass filter, or we pass this sampled signal through a low pass filter, we do not get back our original message signal and we have some distorted triangle, so our signal is also distorted. So we called this as a aliasing. Aliasing is the process in which we do not get back our original message signal as we transmit. And for the aliasing, or we can say aliasing will occur when fs is less than twice of fm or ts is greater than 1 by 2 fm. So in the sampling theorem we said that our fs should be greater than and equal to twice of fm to avoid aliasing, or ts should be less than and equal to 1 by 2 fm. And by keeping this in the mind, when we perform reconstruction of our message signal, then we have a proper message signal without distortion, and that is in the oversampling process fs should be greater than twice of fm. So in this way, to avoid the aliasing, minimum sampling rate is defined as the Nyquist rate, and that is equal to twice of fm, and we denote it as a sample per second, means in a 1 second how many sample we are recorded. And to avoid aliasing, the interval, that is time period, is defined as the maximum Nyquist rate, and it is denoted by 1 by 2 fm, and its unit is in second because time is measured in the second. So in this way we reconstruct our message signal from the sampled signal.